We're going to continue factoring quadratic expressions, but this time you might see that we have a coefficient other than 1 for a. If you think about the ax squared plus bx plus c format, there's a bit of a difference here because we have 3 in, as the coefficient of x squared. So we're going to talk about this situation a little bit more in depth, and hopefully that'll bring some understanding here. So what we need to do is test, you know, some possible factors. You're going to find that in factoring quadratic expressions like this, that you'll have to do some trial and error. So let's try 3x times x. Of course, that is going to be the situation regardless, but I might have to change the positions. But for now, we'll have 3x in the first binomial and x in the second. So let's see if this works out. I need something that multiplies to be 2 and adds to 7. So let's see, 3x times x forces 3x squared. And two times one, of course, is 2. Okay, waiting. Okay, here we go. 3x times 2 is 6x. Okay, of course, I'm showing it here, 3x times 2. We also need to add there a 1 times x, right? And 1 times 2 is 2. So it looks like this is going to work out because, you know, 6x is the result of 3x times 2. And then 1x, or 1 times x is x. So 6x plus x is 7x. And so therefore, my original guess is correct. 3x plus 1. Times x plus 2 is the pair of linear expressions that is the factored form of 3x squared plus 7x plus 2. Now, this is what would have happened if I would have tried x first in the first position and 3x in the other. So, of course, I would still get 3x squared. All right, but then 3x times 1 is 3x, and 2 times x is 2x, so I would only get 5x for the middle, and that wouldn't work out. Okay,